begin with when I switched to the two positions called H-alpha. These words stand for hydrogen alpha, and they are called hydrogen because the light that we see comes from light radiated by hydrogen atoms in the sun's atmosphere. Now, this light is in the visible wavelength range, and you can actually see these things, these pictures on the ground as well. They're about the only instruments that we have of that nature. And we use them here because we see much of the fine detail on the sun at these wavelengths radiated by the hydrogen atoms. For example, we can see sunspots, we can see network, we can see filaments, all of these things on the sun in great detail. Now, the next display that I'd like to discuss briefly is a white light coronagraph. Now, this coronagraph also records or images pictures in the visible part of the wavelength. But it has a very unique feature which makes it something that cannot be observed very often from the ground. And this is, it has some occulting discs out in front of the telescope so that the center of the image, the disc of the sun, is blotted out. And all we see is the very faint light coming in from the solar corona. Now, those of us on the ground can only see this at those very infrequent intervals when we have a total eclipse of the sun. Now up here, we're essentially looking at a total solar eclipse all day long, and we monitor the changes that occur in the corona, and once we tie all of our pre-missions together here in Skylab, we will have monitored the changes that occur in the solar corona over a period of over 5 months.